good to see you all again.
You too.
How have y'all been since the last session?
Not great.
Not great, not so much. What do you think, Deja?
No major changes.
No major changes. I know last time you guys seemed maybe a little bit at odds about your opinions on reproduction and where we wanted to go with that. So that hasn't really changed much.
No.
All right, we can definitely talk about that today. How about just general communication in the home since then? How has that been going?
I feel like I am really willing to talk about the issues that we're having. But Deja just wants to shut down and put them aside or forget about them.
Right.
And I'm putting so much out there by trying to express what I want to say, but then she's non-responsive or not willing to communicate back or wants to ignore it, and that's really frustrating to me.
Yeah, I can definitely understand that. Sounds like you're frustrated and really wanting to communicate, so it sounds like you're willing, and maybe you feel like she's not as willing. Is that what you're saying?
Yeah.
What about you, Deja? What do you think about the communication in the home lately?
Kind of just don't want to talk about it anymore, like the situation, set to what I want to do, and then she's like trying to convince me, and I'm like, no, I'm done with it, don't want to talk about it.
Okay, so you're just kind of tired of beating a dead horse, you're tired of going over the same things over and over again.
Right.
Yeah, both of those things can be frustrating. I think when you're not on the same page as far as communication, it can definitely be hard just to do everyday tasks and to function as a family. So that's definitely something that we want to address in here and get worked out. And I think that you all do an excellent job at communicating your feelings, so I think that that's going to be really beneficial. So we didn't really get to get much into your opinions and desires for reproduction and where you want to go from here. In the last session, I know we just kind of introduced ourselves, and I just kind of got to know you guys. So, Paige, could you tell me what's going on from your perspective?
I would really like to adopt. This is something that I've always really wanted to do. It is something that Deja knew before we became partners that I wanted to do. Because we can't obviously reproduce together, I feel like adoption is the only way to go, and there are so many children out there that need to be adopted, and it's really rewarding to welcome that new part of our family into our home. And I think that could be a really big good step for us in the right direction, and we're financially stable, we have a good stable home, we live in a good area with good schools, and we could really fill our hearts with having a child in our life, and, you know, adopting a child from a poor area could be beneficial to them as well.
All right. I think that you have a lot of really good intentions. It sounds like you're excited about starting a family, and maybe you'd be happy to bring someone out of a poor situation and be able to invite them into a better home. Deja, how do you feel? What's going on from your perspective?
I just maybe want to try a different route. I just don't think that the whole adoption thing would be good. I mean, it's a long process, and we don't know what we're getting into until we get the child. And she's thinking international, so, like, that's even a longer process, and I'm trying to figure out what child we get, and it's negatives and positives, that's
what I'm thinking. So, did you say that you were looking, maybe into in vitro, more so?
I said that last section because I think I want my, like, DNA genetics and stuff to be a part of the child. You know, just to have a child that maybe looks like me and other things that could come with doing that.
So Paige, I saw that you might have had some feelings that kind of came out in expressions then. Could you tell me a little bit about how you feel about what she said?
Yeah, I think it's selfish. There's a lot of children out there that could use good homes, and obviously we can't reproduce on our own. So she said she wants genetics that she's sure about, but if we have a sperm donor, there's still a 50% chance of not knowing who that person is. And there are children up for adoption out there that are already needing homes now, as opposed to waiting for in vitro. And I just think, you know, she wants some of her genes. Well, then what about me? You know, if something happens to us, if we, heaven forbid, if we get a divorce or something, then will the court see it as whosever egg we end up using has more legal rights to that child? That just doesn't make sense to me.
Yeah, I can definitely understand those concerns. And it sounds like you might be a little bit hurt from what you're taking from what Deja is saying. So is this a discussion that you all have tried to go over at home or not as much?
I've tried.
You tried. Oh, yes, you said you tried. And so have you all discussed in vitro, Paige? How do you feel about maybe further discussing whose genes you would use? Did you?
I mean, I know that there's that process where, like, they can mix the eggs or whatever, so you don't know whose it is. But also, I mean, look at us. I'm white. She's black. It'll be very obvious when we have the child whose it is biologically. I just think a child that is adopted is a fresh slate for both of us, and it's kind of an even situation. I mean, related to me or not, even if it were Deja's genes, obviously I'd love it, of course, but I just think it would give us an equal opportunity to love this child.
Deja, how do you feel about what she said?
I mean, I understand where she's coming from, but just, I think she's eager to start family and get this child, and like I said, the process of the whole thing would take so long that she would possibly not even want to do it anymore after everything that we go through. Maybe we could think of a different route of just like fostering the child first, and then maybe that's something that we could do before going all the way into the whole adoption thing.
Okay, so it sounds like you have some reservations just about adopting a child who you're not familiar with. Is
right.
that kind of what you're saying?
Yeah.
And so have you at all possibly considered working closely with an adoption agency and asking about that process? And have you all checked into that at all? And have you seen what that looks like kind of mapped out?
Not too much yet, because we hadn't even come to a conclusion on what we wanted.
Yeah, I think we do have resources here where we can kind of hook you up with an adoption agency and let you see what that process would look like, just so that you can get a for sure opinion and you can kind of know, because you might end up loving the process and you might end up hating it, you know, once you see how it actually will play out. And I think that it would give you all a better foundation in order to that you would build on as far as opinions on adoption and things like that. And also with in vitro, how far have you all looked into that?
We really haven't. We hadn't gone past the discussion on either phase because we barely even had a discussion about it. It's normally an argument.
And is there any time that you all did discuss it when the result or the communication was done in a positive way?
I can't think of a time except for when before we were married and I first expressed that I wanted to adopt.
And do you remember what Deja's reaction was to that.
She seemed positive and like it would be something that she'd be interested in, but I think then it was one of those very distant thoughts,
mm-hmm.
and now that it's real, it's getting a different reaction.
Yeah. So Deja, aside from the not knowing who the child is and not being familiar with them, do you have any other concerns? I know that you mentioned financial concerns in our last session, but other than that, are there any concerns that you've had?
Those are basically the main concerns, just time, not knowing, and finances. Anything else, then it would be something that we wouldn't have any control over. If something else comes up, it would just be there, and it would just be another situation or issue that we just have to deal with, like, in there. So I guess I'm scared of what might happen that's not planned out.
So it sounds like you might be a little bit fearful, yeah, of just being unfamiliar with it, and have some reservation because this isn't something that you've done before. Is that what you're saying?
Right.
I definitely think that if you all worked with the services that we have here to kind of get a feel for and an understanding for that process, I think that that would definitely be beneficial. Is there anything else that you can think of concerning adoption that would maybe help the other person understand where you're coming from? Paige, we'll start with you.
I mean, I'm scared too. This isn't something that I'm jumping into fully confident that we know how it's going to work. I think anyone that has a child ever is going to be scared the whole time. I'm not completely I have fears too, is what I'd like you to know.
So Deja, how do you feel about that, knowing that she's also afraid?
It's kind of a good feeling, not that she's scared, but that we're on the same page. I guess that we have came to agreement that we are both scared about the situation.
Yeah, I think that you all are both definitely brave women. I think that you all seem to have desire to have a life together, and that's a strength that we can build on. It seems like you all both want a family, just from what you're telling me. And I think that you seem willing to communicate. So on a scale of 1 to 10, with 1 being not willing at all, completely just set on your way, and a 10 being, completely willing to understand where the person's coming from and willing to change your mind about that, where would you say that you fall as far as changing it between in vitro and adoption?
Seven.
Well, I think that sounds great. You all are both above halfway. You're both willing to. And I think that you all seem to really care about each other and to want to communicate effectively. And I think that that's going to be beneficial in working this all out. And so we're going to set you up with some services at the front desk whenever you leave, that will kind of walk you through the process of what an adoption looks like, walk you through the process of what in vitro looks like. And then also kind of show you a few pamphlets on fostering, since you said that you were interested in that.
I need just a little more Jesus.